Welcome to Talking Fashion, the weekly broadcast featuring community leaders who know and understand the power of dressing for success. Join Robert Ford and friends as they build a legacy of productive men through character, leadership, and fashion. So are you ready to empower?
I can hear you.
Ready to make a difference?
Come on, I can feel it.
Ready to change lives?
Can you feel it?
Join Robert Ford and friends. It's genuine, authentic, candid talk. Just keeping it real. Can you feel it? Welcome to Talking Fashion with your host, Robert Ford.
Hello, guys. Thank you for tuning in. Talking Fashion with Robert Ford and friends. I have three great friends with me today. Man, we got an outstanding show for you. The first time on Talking Fashion with Robert Ford that we're gonna be talking to our young lady throughout Mississippi, throughout the surrounding state, and across the country. Cause we talking fashion to our young ladies that really need this here. Cause our boys, our young men, we got this. Yes, we do, we got this here. So, three powerful young ladies. One is from Fort Lauderdale, but original from Jackson, Mississippi. Get ready. Get ready. Get ready. You better have your seatbelt on, because right now, I want to bring my beautiful friends up to the stage. Here we go. Are you guys ready? I'm ready. First, Miss Thomas. Come on up, my sweetie. Come on up. She got the blue on. What you got? Rock with me a little bit. All right, here we go, here we go, here we go. My second friend, this girl is powerful, business lady. Man, she can make it happen. Insurance, you ever need some great insurance, come to this lady, Ms. Myers. So at this time, I want to introduce my friend from Callaway High School, from Jackson State D.I. Love University, Ms. Myers. Come on up, girl. You got to keep it rocking now. What you got? With these tall ladies, we can start a basketball team. Here we go. Here we go. Come on, keep it going. Keep it going. Boy, we're going to have a show for you guys. Hey, guys, don't get jealous out there. Don't get jealous. This is my show. Here we go. This beautiful lady. Born and raised in Jackson, Mississippi. Now resides in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. The Sunshine State. Oh, you sit there right now. I got you. I got you. I want you to come. I want you to make this grand entry. Oh, my goodness. She got it going on. A graduate of Jackson State University, D.I. Love. My friend. Miss Powell, come on up. Come on up, girl. Show me what you got. There you go. Come on, show what you got, girl. Here we go. Come on. Yeah, walk it out. Walk it out. Are you a date yet? Oh, I don't know now. Come on. Come on, ladies. Let's rock this thing. Oh, I'm sorry, from Moss Point, Mississippi. Mississippi Gulf Coast, I'm sorry. So guys, stay tuned. We got something coming for you young ladies here in Jackson. Hey, you ladies in Jackson, you need to listen to these ladies right now on my show. So stay tuned. Talking Fashion with Ms. Powell, Ms. Myers, and Ms. Thomas. We'll be back shortly. What we got?
Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Mississippi partners with our communities to promote living healthy. With the compassion of the cross and the security of the shield, we're empowering you to take control of your personal wellness journey and to find the joy of being active at every age and helping you build proud, healthy communities with a heart of hospitality, because it's about you, your health, your life. Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Mississippi. It's good to be blue.
Hey guys, welcome back to Talking Fashion with Robert Ford. We got a little Janet Jackson going for you guys, man. I have three beautiful young ladies, man, on this talk show. This is the first ever episode that we're talking about fashion to young ladies in the city of Jackson, Mississippi, and surrounding cities, states, and throughout the country. So these ladies are gonna bring you some great information. Right, ladies?
Right.
So at this time, I'd like to introduce each one of them starting off with Ms. Powell. Can you tell us your full name, where you're from, and what you're doing?
Hi, I'm Wincie Powell. I am the founder of the Powell of Love Incorporated. We are a nonprofit social change network promoting love as the core principle of life. I currently reside in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, South Florida, north of Miami, south of West Palm Beach. But I'm originally from the Mississippi Gulf Coast, and I am a proud graduate of the I Love.
Come on, baby, come on! Whoa, my wife, I know I got something to say. I don't have anything. Jackson State University, D, I love, baby. I love Jackson State. And you got to forgive me now. Hey, this is my show, so I'm going to act a nut on the show. And a good call. We're going to do it in a good, positive way.
Thank you for having me.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you so much. She flew in yesterday, man. And when you get somebody to come on your talk show, when you got a major hurricane in the Gulf of Mexico, Lord Jesus, we're doing something right.
Yes.
And the cause, the reason why we're doing this talk show, to reach out to our young people in our city, in our state, in our country. Thank you for that. Thank you.
Thank you.
Miss Brenda Miles,
yes.
Talk to our audience who you are, what you do, and just show a little love on it too. Put a little flavor on it.
Oh, absolutely. Well, I am Brenda Myers. I am CEO and founder of Journey Insurance Solutions. I am also CEO and founder of Boss Babe Lady Boss, which is an online t-shirt shop for female entrepreneurs.
Oh, what happened to the man t-shirt shop?
It's coming.
Okay. Well, we'll make that announcement on my show.
And I am the author of Becoming an Entrepreneur, My Pink Slip Defining Moment. And I'm from Jackson, Mississippi, and the I love.
Oh, Lord, let me see here. Somebody got to put something in my cup for the I love, baby. My homegirl. Oh, Lord, here we go. Mr. Thomas.
Yes, sir.
My friend.
Mr. Ford.
Oh, we go back.
A long way.
We go back. Fashion shows.
We do.
Speaking engagement. Mississippi Absolutely. State University.
I travel the road with
travel,
you.
Yes, you do. Introduce yourself to our audience.
I am Christiane Thomas. I am
who?
Christiane Thomas.
Oh, you're not. You got to. I thought it was.
Oh,
Christine.
I'm sorry. You want me to. Well,
you call me Roberto.
Well, I'm Christine for him.
Okay. No, I'll go ahead. We're going to have fun, guys. We're going to have. All I got to say, get loose, but put your seatbelt on because we're going to get wild up here, baby. We're gonna do what, ladies?
Get
keep
wild.
It real.
Keep it real. We're gonna keep it real.
On three. One, two, three.
Keep it real.
We're gonna keep it real, baby. Come on.
I am a part of the D.I. Love family also.
Oh, Lord Jesus.
I'm originally from Port Gibson, Mississippi.
Okay.
I have one son that you have poured over
yes.
into for the last, I forgot how many years. That
it's
was five, six
about
years.
Kevin.
Kelvin, he is. I'm a
buddy.
Part of the criminal justice field. I've been in law enforcement for 25 years. Through my years of experience, I started a training called Leading by Example, where it teaches people about the importance of mental health, what is mental health, how to identify it, and the resources. And it has taken off and been endorsed by, you know, state agencies. And, you know, I'm just grateful for what God has done for me and for putting
Amen.
People like you in my life.
All right, you've been a blessing.
Perfect.
You've truly
Perfect.
Been a blessing in my
mm-hmm.
life. And I thank each and every last one of you guys. But I want to keep this here real for you guys. Like I said, this is our first show during these beautiful three ladies, man. And let me tell you guys why we decided to do a talk show with our ladies. One of my clients, Amber Young, 14 years old, go to Germantown High School. She's taking golf lessons from me. She said, Mr. Ford, Coach Ford, I watch your talk show. You're funny. You got a lot of energy. I love it. But I'm being biased. Where's the ladies?
Mm-hmm.
I'm talking, she was really serious.
Mm-hmm.
Our young black girls need to hear what you telling our young black boys in our city.
Mm-hmm.
So please do a talk show for young black girls here in Jackson, Mississippi and surrounding city.
Mm-hmm.
And I couldn't pick a better team to open, do this grand open for our ladies and our young girls with these fine three young ladies. That's why. So Amber, We love you. Thank you for motivating me to do what I have to do to get the message out there, not to just young men, but also young girls. So thank you, Amber. We love you. So ladies, here we go, here we go, here we go, here we go. So we're gonna start, Miss Thomas.
Oh boy.
We're gonna start with you.
Yes, sir.
You know, you're around a lot of important people, okay? Why dress up when you go out to different events and just make your mark with other important people in life and throughout Jackson, Mississippi?
Clothes, you know, when you put on those clothes, it make you, it elevate you to a whole nother level. I go back and reflect on what my grandmother always told me. I'm grateful for her. You know, she poured into me like no other. You know, being young, coming up in a small town, people always referred to the color of my skin and the texture of my hair.
Come on.
And so my grandmother would sit me on the porch, and she was a beautiful, fair-skinned woman with wide hips, but I was their little chocolate grandchild.
What
granddaughter, chocolate. So she always would talk to me about, you know, when she was doing my hair, and you know, I had hair, long hair, and people would walk up all the time and say, you know, Julia, that's a pretty girl to be so black. Where'd she get that hair from?
Uh-oh, come on.
So that didn't set well with my grandmother, but she sat me down and she explained to me. She said, let me explain something to you. By the time you turn 40, your hair will be white as snow, matched against the context of your skin. And she said, when you walk into a room, mm-hmm. own it. And she said, I mean own it from the top of your head to the bottom of your feet.
Tell our young
walk
girls
into
to
a
own
room,
it.
You own it. And you know, God give you what he wants you to have just for you to do it. Out of all of my grandmother's kids, grandkids, I'm the only one that inherit the hair that she had.
Wow.
So, you know, he give it to the one he wants to make sure he's going to take care of it. So it's important for me, you know, even going to church, I used to tell people, I love to dress up for Jesus.
Hold up now, this is the first episode now. We ain't got to go to church.
We ain't
got
to do that. We're always going to do that.
Him
now. Now,
don't leave me hanging.
I'm sorry.
Guys, we're going to have a lot of fun. I love it. And we talk about our grandmothers so much. You know, I miss my grandmother, man. You know, she was Creole Indian. She had beautiful long hair, you know, light complexion, green eyes. You know, I miss her so much. And we're going to talk about our grandmothers and our families and people who are very close to us. And I know in my family, you just can't go out looking any kind of way.
Oh, right. Absolutely.
Hello?
Right. No, sir.
You just can't go out looking any kind of way.
No.
So these young ladies and young guys is just going out. We're going to talk about this here. Jackson State Homecoming. When I was living in St. Louis, I came back for homecoming. And I'm going to share that with you guys because my producer said we got to go to commercial. Hey, guys, stay tuned. Talking Fashion with my friends, Miss Powell, Miss Myers, and Miss Thomas. We'll be back shortly. Stay tuned.
Circuits deliver power by making connections. At Entergy, we believe that works for people, too. The next generation is our connection to the future. So every year, Entergy invests millions of dollars in education to teach skills for better jobs, to build a brighter path. To us, making connections means more than electricity. It means fulfilling promise. And together, we power life. Entergy.
Guys, welcome back to Talking Fashion with Bob Ford and friends. Our lady edition, our young lady. We want to get something to our young ladies in the city of Jackson. And I'm going to keep overemphasizing that, our young ladies in Jackson. Our first episode, our first show, guys, and we want you guys to be a part of this here. So we're talking about grandmothers and Ray Ray, Nut Nut, Poo Poo, and Suzanne, and May Ann, and all these funny names that we came up with. You know, you gotta know what I'm talking about, mm-hmm. you know. Mother Ann, and who else?
Nicknames,
mm-hmm. Absolutely. So, Miss Powell. Coming up in Moss Point, Mississippi, what did your family mean to you when it comes to dressing and carrying yourself in a very professional way? It could be your mom, your grandmother, your auntie, you know, it could be my dear. ain't talking about Tyler Perry either. I'm talking about Mud Deer. We all got a Mud Deer.
Actually, my mom is Mud Deer.
Oh, I'm sorry, Mud Deer. I'm sorry.
But nevertheless, foundation, as she spoke about, is actually essential to your deciding factor and how you present yourself to the world. I've been fortunate enough to be supported by a grounded family of humility who take pride in how you present yourself, credibility in the home, credibility in the community, and I'm grateful for that. Yes, how you present yourself, putting yourself to the forefront, and how you're being is actually essential in what you want your environment to be.
Oh, that's powerful.
Yes.
That's powerful.
So I've always been taught by my mom. She's more conservative than I am. I'm kind of over the top. Like, everybody know that I'm over the top.
Wait, hold on. Over the top what?
I'm over the top. Anybody who know me, come in contact with me, always say, you're just so extra, you know. And that's about being part of who you are and what you're created to do and what you're created to be and bring to the universe.
I can't even be still now. You're talking over the top. I must be wild then, man. You know, my producers and executive producers, and all, you need to sit your butt down somewhere. You're too active.
And I've always been told that. Get somewhere and sit out. However, it's important and essential that our youth know that you have been created with your own unique gift.
Ooh,
what you bring to the world. So embrace that and bring that to the forefront. And my mother, she always supported me in everything that I did, even though we may not have the same idea of what the next step would be. But I always use her and my dad in every decision that I make. Whatever I put on, will they approve?
Right. Mm-hmm.
If they don't approve, if it's questionable, leave it alone.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Not going
to
happen.
So to speak. So I'm grateful. The Mississippi Gulf Coast is where I was raised. Home of a lot of legends.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm grateful.
You're a legend. In a good way. In a positive way. Just all you do, all the work you do, you're giving back. And girl, you bad.
Oh.
You bad. You better than Michael Jackson.
You
bad.
One of my favorite.
You bad.
So much.
I mean that. You know, I keep up with you. You know, we're friends, and you know, we attend the same university. You know, we family up here.
Yeah,
we family. So I appreciate you so much. I'm going to cut you off because you kind of like my brother, long-winded. In a good way.
I'm okay with that.
Hey, we all like to, I know I like to talk.
Right.
I might not come out right, but I'm going to talk.
I understand. Yes.
What do family, growing up as a beautiful young lady in your household, okay, what that mean? What did it really mean to you? You know, what did family do to you to get you to that level that you want to be professional, you want to speak elegant, you want to wear beautiful clothes, you know what I'm saying? You want to go to that next level.
Absolutely. Well, you know, I remember when
Look,
I was
she's
a kid.
So smooth. Well, I remember. You're so smooth, girl. Go ahead on. You're so smooth.
I just remember when I was a kid in elementary school, and you get your new school clothes when the school year is about to start.
That's right.
I just remember being so proud.
All right, hold up. Let me back up. When school started for us, you better hope you had a pair of pants put on. New school clothes.
Yeah.
We got to talk about that because I'm not used to that.
Well, we were fortunate. I mean, my father worked really hard to make sure we had everything we needed. We might not have had everything we wanted,
right,
but we had everything we needed. But I just remember the first day of school, putting my little dress on with my knee socks, and I walked in that classroom like I was like, I'm here.
Right.
You know, so it was instilled in us from a young age, you know, to always put your best face forward because somebody's watching.
Someone's watching,
and somebody is, you know, you're an example for somebody. So, and I have a daughter, and I instilled in her, you know, always, always look your best no matter what. And my mom would not allow us to go outside the house with slippers on. My mom.
Come on.
She would not allow us to go out of the house with slippers on, let alone go to a store.
Right.
You know, Because what we see now, you know, it has to be talked about.
Right.
You know, it has to be talked about. So I appreciate both my parents for instilling those values in us. Mm-hmm. My dad would tell us, you know, he passed away in 2018, bless his heart.
Take your time.
But he would tell us, always hold your head up. You know, no matter what you're going through, hold your head up and always look your best, you know. So those are just the things that I remember growing up with the values that I have. And I appreciate my parents, too, for, you know, for instilling those things in us.
Right. Wow. Another powerful question I have for you ladies. I mean, you can kind of, whoever want to go first with this here is okay with me. What do dressing for success mean to you guys? And when we come back on the next show, I call it episode, but my team says show, so we're doing shows. So we'll come back and touch on something else related to that. But what do dressing for success mean to you? And when did you decide you want to dress for success? Oh, wait, that's so good. When did you decide that you want to dress for success?
Mm-hmm.
And what does dressing for success mean to you? Mm-hmm. To you? Anyone, whoever.
Oh, I'll go first.
Okay.
Clothes.
Oh, I go first. I'm sorry, go ahead. Go ahead on, Brenda. You know, I love you, girl. I'm just messing with you.
Well, dressing for success is the modern day clothes make it the man. You know, back then you put your clothes on and you said, man, you know, look how good he look in his clothes or whatever. But now, you know, dressing for success or dress for success, it has the same message, you know, and the way you present yourself to the world, you know, that says a lot about you, your character, you know, and it's a determining factor as to whether someone wants to work with you or not. You know, you can go into an interview and you're looking, you know, not the best, and they're judging you. You might be the perfect person for the job, but your appearance is telling them, well, it might not be the right fit. But if you go back into that same interview dressed, you know, appropriately, then, you know, you would probably automatically get the job.
Wow.
But yeah, all of that, you know, is important. All of that is important. Fashion, it says a lot about you as a person.
Okay.
Yeah.
And the second part of that question, when did you decide that dressing for success?
Mm-hmm.
When did you decide that? You know, as a young lady, you know, I'm talking about 12, mm-hmm. 10, 14, 15, when?
I think when I decided what career I wanted to have, I knew that it was important to dress a certain way. So I remember being in school and I would wear like dresses and business suits to class, and you know, everybody's like, why are you dressing like that? Because I was dressing for the role that I wanted to have in life. And so now,
say that again.
I was dressing for the role that I wanted to have in life.
Say that again.
I was dressing for the role that I wanted to have in life.
Can I get a choir? Well.
Yeah. And so
that's
it's
so powerful.
Over.
You have to dress for success.
Yeah.
Where you want to go in life. Yes.
Right.
I'm telling you.
Yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Very good. Very good. So we have 1 minute. And what we're going to do, we're going to go ahead and go to commercial break, because we're going to come back with that same question to you guys. Okay, guys, thank you so much for tuning in. Please listen to these beautiful ladies, man. These more, just so professional, so powerful, man. Young ladies, stay with us. We'll be back talking fashion with Robert Ford and friends. We'll be back shortly. Hey guys, welcome back to Talking Fashion with Robert Ford and friends. You know, I had 3 friends before we left and went to commercial, but guess what? We have 4 now. My good friend, House of Representatives, Miss Summers. Let's give her a hand. So let's give her a hand. Hey, thank you for coming on the show.
Thank you for having me.
What district do you represent?
District 68, highest in ranking.
What I want you to do is talk to that camera right there, to your audience. Just tell them a little bit about you and what are you doing.
Sure. So I'm Zakiya Summers. I have the honor and privilege of serving House District 68, which covers Hines and Rankin County. This is my first term. I'm going into my third session, and we're working very hard for the people in the district. I'm also a former election commissioner for Hinds County, and so voting rights is one of my passions, and I've been fighting and working very hard to protect your vote and defend your vote. And again, I want to thank you so much, Mr. Ford, for having me.
Thanks for being here. Man, this is awesome. I'm bored. Ms. Larry, can we get another 2 hours? Mr. Rush, we had to. You're going to stay right there. You're good. So we're gonna get back to this conversation, man. We're trying to get a message to our young people, our young girls, because this is our first show we ever done talking about girls instead of our young men, okay? It's so important that we give this quality, this so important information to our young people, especially young ladies. So if you had to talk to a young lady, an African-American young lady here in the city of Jackson and surrounding cities, surrounding state, and throughout the country, what would you say to that young girl about dressing for success? And second part of that, two-part question, how would you carry yourself? How should that young lady carry herself by dressing for success?
Sure, so I would first tell her that she is already beautifully made.
Somebody close the back door. She's already what?
Beautifully made.
Lord Jesus.
She is perfect just the way she is.
Ding. Let me sit here and just go head on. Because I'm going to get bored. You just hit a nerve there. Already beautiful.
And dressing for success is like adding the cherry on top of the ice cream.
See, she came and she hit the nerve now. What's on top of the ice cream?
Just putting that little chair, that just little extra.
That little nugget.
The extra.
To what you already are.
Wow.
Which is a beautiful, important, valued young lady.
Wow.
Absolutely.
That's exactly what I would
say. Man, we can close the show out on that one. But you know what? We're going to keep it going. Wow, that's awesome. What would you tell a young Black young lady here in the city of Jackson and surrounding city and throughout the state of Mississippi, what would you tell a young Black girl about dressing for success? And how should you carry yourself? You know, to me, I have a daughter. Before you answer that question, I remember my daughter was in high school. She's a senior. I remember she came downstairs. I'll never forget this here. She walked downstairs. I said, "What the? I almost cussed. What are you doing?" And Robin, you know I love you, sweetheart. I love you. You're very successful in life. I love you. But she would testify to this here. She had something on like Daisy Dukes and some long heels up to here. Where are you going? Today is Monday. Where are you going? I'm going to school, Dad. No, school's out of session. You ain't going. Not looking like that. Oh, no. So I had to check my daughter. I had to check my daughter about the way that she was going to walk out of my household with that name forward and going to this very prestige high school.
Yes.
I said, oh, no, not today.
Right.
Not tomorrow. No. Not next year. Never.
Right.
Thank you.
And I can say now daughter was one of the top model, one of the top pageant girl in the state of Mississippi. Miss Mississippi Teen America, Miss Runner-Up at Mississippi State 3 years in a row.
Awesome.
So she's a bad sister. Because I made sure that she carried and conduct herself in a very professional way.
Absolutely.
So go ahead and answer that. I just had to share that story.
Thank you for sharing that. But we need people to impact us. We need people to influence us because we don't always have that good judgment, especially with media.
I know I was a fool growing up, so I need all the judgment I need, boy. I'm talking about I was crazy.
Things have changed. So I want to emphasize what she said. You're already beautiful.
Oh, yes.
You know, and it's just cherry on the top. And also piggyback what she said. You want to actually dress what you foresee yourself to be. You want to already foresee where you want to be, and you want to prepare and present yourself in that manner. And that's something I've always adapted, you know, even at an early age, a young lady. I've always known that I wanted something bigger than what I saw. So with that said, I created a persona of where I wanted to be.
Right.
And I thank God I had the parents to instill in me.
You had what?
Parents.
You had what?
Parents.
Amen, church. I'm not going to get the choir to sing right now, but amen.
To instill in me and to actually structure my decision. Mm-hmm. You know, like you said, as a dad, you say, where are you going? But for me, that was like many moons ago. But at the same time, when I would dress, would they be proud of me and
right.
how I present
yes.
myself?
Ooh.
The name.
Hold on. Say that one more time. If who would be proud of you?
If my parents.
Say it again.
If my parents would be proud of me of
That's
how
huge.
I presented myself. Am I a representation of what they stand for?
Yes. Absolutely.
And the accreditation of their name, the Powell.
Right.
Absolutely.
So that was my decision. But as long as you have that person to step in and say, no, no.
And it's okay to say no, right?
Yeah, it's okay to say no.
It's okay to say no.
You know, mm-hmm. It's okay.
This is not appropriate, not yeah. for this occasion.
Right.
So let's fix it before it get out of hand.
Yeah.
Very, very good. Mm-hmm. Ms. Brenda.
Yeah, they have to learn somewhere. Somebody has to teach them. You know,
because can I touch on that?
Sure.
I'm geeked up. I'm fired up right now. If they don't learn from home, where are they going to get it from?
Right. They have to see us as examples representing what young ladies are supposed to look like.
Come on.
Yes.
Yeah. And then they'll know and be inspired to, you know, to look their best.
Mm-hmm.
So, but, you know, young ladies, they need role models just like the young guys. They need role models. They need people to tell them or show them, you know, how they can be successful, what it's going to take for them to get to the next level. So, but yeah, we all are representatives of, you know, our young girls. When
yes.
we were young, you know, and we had people to teach us and show us and tell us what was appropriate and what wasn't appropriate. And sometimes young girls or even young guys, you know, they think they're victims of their surroundings or,
right.
or where they came from as kids,
mm-hmm.
you know, but you don't have to stay there. You know what I'm saying?
Say that again.
You don't have to stay there where you came from.
Right.
You know, it doesn't make who you are.
Right.
You know, you have so many levels. And I even think about, you know, people that came from humble beginnings and mm-hmm. then they're millionaires now. You know? So,
absolutely.
What, Tommy Hilfiger figure selling shirts and stuff out of the back of his trunk?
Oh, yeah. Jeff Bezos from
yeah.
Amazon
yeah.
in his basement.
Ooh, yeah. Ooh, I saw his story.
Oh, absolutely. Even Walt Disney. Mm-hmm. You
oh,
know.
Can we talk about you?
Absolutely.
And everything that you do
Absolutely.
For the young men.
Take the picture. Take him.
Right.
Take
Absolutely.
His picture.
So, yeah, they have to have that role model. They
yeah.
have to have
Absolutely.
Someone to fix what they can aspire to be.
You know, so, my mother, you know, yeah. I should have had a picture on stage. You guys probably seen
beautiful.
Her.
Mm-hmm.
My mom is so beautiful. Jet magazine, Essence, and all that stuff. You know, I wanted to make my mom proud of me. And this show is all about fun. Let me tell you something, guys. My girls out there, my guys, my young guys. It's not about this suit that we have on, okay? It's not about these beautiful outfits these ladies have on. It's about your integrity. It's about your character, who you are as a person, and what you want to be. I just did a speaking engagement up in Memphis at a powerful mega church up there. And my topic was great. I want to be great.
Mm-hmm.
How do you get there?
Mm-hmm.
So when we come back, you better be ready. We're going to talk about greatness. So stay tuned. Talking Fashion with Robert Ford. My friend, my friend, my friend, my friend. I love them all. We'll be back shortly.
Hey guys, Coach Prime is coming today to pick up his 21 Escalade. What time is it?
Prime time!
I gotta go. He's going to be here soon.
Still got it.
Really? Oh, Lord. Now this is Prime.
Get your Prime deal today at Cadillac of Jackson.
Guys, welcome back to Talking Fashion with Robert Ford and friends. Guys, we're talking to some beautiful ladies up here to get a message to our young ladies. So, we're going to go back to Ms. Thomas. What would you tell a young black lady, a beautiful young black lady, about dressing for success and how you should carry yourself?
Always be a lady first. No matter what you do, where you go, who you with,
Be the woman that God made you.
Ooh.
And one of the things as a mother raising a boy, I always pride myself that my son never will be ashamed to point out and say, that's my mama. You know, when I walked into the school, walked into a field,
my mom
wherever.
Hold up now. My mom up there in heaven is just smiling. She loving you right now.
Absolutely.
I mean,
that was just something, you know, and I always, you know, I raised my son, you know, because I knew as a woman how I wanted to be treated.
Right.
So that's the book I use for him, you know, open the doors, be polite, you know, make sure that you are a gentleman. I taught him if we walking down the sidewalk, even now as an adult, you know, you get to the outside, put me in the inside because you need to be my protector. Even though I'm your mama, you still got to do that.
You're teaching right now.
So those are some things that I, you know, and it came from being around other women of standards that was older than me, standards that had standards and value, and wanted to make sure, you know, the biggest thing is, and I'm just kind of give you my background and my story. My mom passed when I was 5.
Wow.
A man, my daddy, raised 9 of us. I'm the baby of the group. So, you know, he was not the most educated man, but, you know, he made me, I was a true athlete.
Right.
But the day he told me I had to go to debutante, I was like, this is child abuse.
I wanted to go to debutante. I couldn't afford a tuxedo, so I couldn't go.
I was like, I was like, Dad, I just don't think this is going to be a good thing, you know, because here I am, the basketball, track, and all. He said, you never know where life is gonna take you.
Wow.
You don't know who you may be sitting with. And I am, you know, grateful to God, to him to this day, because God knows I have gone some places that people still ask me, how did you get there? But you know, you gotta always carry yourself. And you know, even dressing, back to what Ms. Powell said, you know, I walked in and Brenda to a training, I was a speaker, and the guy said, oh goodness, you dressed in a suit and carrying one of them high dollar bags, we're gonna have to pay you. So, you know, it's all about how you go in. You know, you know, you gotta, your first, they say first impression, it is lasting.
It is.
You know, because you can walk up in there with some hot shorts and some, and a cut-off shirt, and they be like, where in the world? But you walk in there with a business suit on. And I showed that to my son one day. I say, I'm gonna show you how people will treat you by how you dress and walking in the place.
People will treat
you by the way you dress.
Right. Say it again.
So they're gonna treat you the way you dress.
One more time.
They will treat you the way you are dressed.
Now come on in, choir.
Amen. You want your persona to speak for you before you even enter the room.
Right.
I know one guest I had on my show last month, he said, you want you as a person to speak for you, and you don't have to open your mouth.
That's
the way you carry yourself. That was so powerful.
Right.
Now, you better get ready out there, ladies. Young ladies, are we getting ready to get serious now, baby? We're getting ready to get serious. We're going to talk about accessorizing. Accessorizing. How far do we go? What color do we use? Sometimes we go overboard, and sometimes we need to get accessorized. So, ladies, let's talk about this. This day and age, these young ladies now, the way they get accessorized, kind of overdoing it with the pink and purple hair, I'm gonna shut up before I get in trouble. So I'm gonna let you ladies touch on that. Miss Brenda Miles.
Yes.
Touch on that, please. You know, you can accessorize. You look, you know,
you got
the pearls on, you know, beautiful pearls, you know, nice ring, and, you know, that's professional.
Right. Yeah. I mean, what situation you're going into, you have to know how to present yourself. Now, if you're going to one of these little parties where all the kids are doing little fun stuff, you know, that should be temporary.
Right.
That shouldn't be your daily walk with the purple hair and the pink hair and all that. Because people will look at you and they will be like, you know, where are her parents? Why are they allowing her to do that? You know, because you have to grow up at some point. You have to realize that this is not the perception that I want people to have of me.
And one thing, we're not trying to criticize any of you young ladies out there.
Right.
We're trying to get something positive into you. Because I tell you what, you go into the corporate world and say, I'm here for a job. Mm-hmm. And you got pink, blue hair and fingernails with all the colors of the crayons in the box. You know, they're going to tell you to go to the circus.
Right.
We're keeping it real.
You are absolutely right about that. I agree with that 100%.
Accessorize.
It's about being appropriate.
At the right time, right place.
At the right time and the right place. Again, embrace your uniqueness. Mm-hmm. It's okay to have the purple hair. Trend and classic. But you have to know when and where to use or utilize that.
Right.
You know, you don't want to downplay your uniqueness, whatever that is. But at the same time, you have to learn to structure and make the right decisions for the right time. Mm-hmm. So I'm okay with being over the top. Like I said, I'm over the top.
Hey, go ahead, fly girl. Go ahead on.
All the time.
Go ahead on, fly girl.
Hey,
go ahead on.
I mop with heels on. But nevertheless, it's about being appropriate.
But you know what? You look very elegant and very professional with your accessorizing.
Right. You. Well put together.
Yeah, well put together. Great saying. Well put together.
Thank you. What do you think, Zakiya?
I think you're absolutely right. You know, it's a time and place for everything. And it really depends on the kind of industry that you're in or, you know, where you're going. Because I have no problem with young people expressing themselves. They have a freedom to express themselves. And we don't want to put them in a cookie cutter box that they feel like they have to conform to what, you know, society says that they have to be.
But we do want to set them up for success.
We do want to
give them great information.
But
we don't give them the information because we've been through it.
Right.
We're talking about grown people.
Mm-hmm. Right. And then we have to remember, it's something that my husband always tells me, you never get a second chance to make a first impression.
Say that again.
Absolutely right.
You never get a second chance to make a first impression. So, you know, naturally you don't want to go to a job interview with wacky colors and, you know, not having your clothes pressed and that sort of thing. You want to look put together because ultimately you do want to land that job or that opportunity that you're going for. And so it's just like what Ms. Powell says, a time and place for everything. You want to be appropriate and remember that once you meet that person the first time, that's what they're going to remember about you.
That's right.
And they may not be so inclined to bring you back on for something else if you haven't presented yourself well.
Very good. Well spoken. Mm-hmm. Guys, I just want to share something with you guys, young ladies. You know, I have some powerful friends, you know, in my Rolodex. Mm-hmm. And I was going back and looking at one of my dear friend, Miss Condoleezza Wright. Mm-hmm. Okay. I went back and just, eventually she's gonna come on the show. Mm-hmm. And I was going back looking at some of her profile pictures. I said, man, this lady is bad to the bone. You know, she business, every picture I went, you know, I was flipping, every picture just, you know, great outfit. Then I went a little bit further, you know, looking at these very professional pictures. Mm-hmm. Okay. Being the secretary, former secretary of state. Mm-hmm. And over here, she was down to earth. She had a golf outfit on, mm-hmm. a golf outfit on. You know, I said, wow, that's dressing for success. Mm-hmm. Her golf outfit kind of, feel me on this here, guys. Her golf outfit kind of blended in her personality. Mm-hmm. As a professional politician.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
It was so beautiful. Her golf outfit blended in mm-hmm. with her personality. Like you yesterday. Just blended in. Just beautiful. Very professional.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you.
Had a great time.
It was awesome. So guys, we're going to take a commercial break. Talking Fashion with Robert Ford. And friends, my friends, Ms. Thomas, Ms. Summers, Ms. Powell, and Ms. Myra. We'll be back shortly.
The greatest impact we can have on the future is teaching our children to live healthy at home, at play, and at school. Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Mississippi partners with our schools to support them in being places where our children learn about healthy habits and where they are empowered to achieve full academic potential. With the compassion of the Cross and the security of the Shield, Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Mississippi is building a healthy Mississippi.
Hey guys, welcome back to Talking Fashion with Robert Ford and friends, and my friends, my beautiful ladies. Guys, we're gonna keep this rolling. We're having a good time up here. We're giving out some great information to our young ladies. So what we're gonna do kind of like an open mic. You guys okay with that?
Sure.
Open mic. So whatever come, you know, out of your mind thought, just share it with our young ladies, okay? And we're gonna start with Ms. Summers. Represent Summers.
Okay.
What do you want to tell our young ladies out there?
Sure. Well, I had the honor and privilege, I was very fortunate to have a beautiful mother, similar to what you were saying about your son, who set the standard and set the bar for me as well. But I do know that there are young ladies out there that may not have someone in their home or in their community that they can look up to. And so I just want to encourage the young ladies to find somebody, even if it's on the internet, on social media, on television, maybe somebody from school or somebody from church, just someone that you can look up to, that you can ask questions to, someone that will provide you with some good information and help to mold you into the young lady, the beautiful young lady that you already are, but just help you to become the person that you want to be. I was very fortunate to have a lot of women in my community, in my neighborhood, that I looked up to. And they really helped to show me that, Zakiya, you got it. You got it already. You just got to, this is something. Right. And it was one thing, I tell you a story. One of my mentors is Mrs. Calhoun.
Oh, yes.
And when I became an election commissioner, she told me, she said, now you're going to have to start wearing stockings now.
I said,
I don't know about that. She said, yes. She said, you know, you're going to have to wear stockings with your skirts and your dresses because that makes you look a little bit more polished. And I can appreciate that.
A
little bit more polished. I can appreciate that lesson. And we know that, you know, women come from different generations you know, you wouldn't dare come out the house as a woman without stockings.
Right.
I think you call it pantyhose.
Stocking what? Stocking shelves? You know, food?
I don't wear stockings, normally, but I understood what she was saying. I totally understood what she was saying. That in my position as an elected official, as a professional woman, as a mother, as a community leader, when I come out the house, I need to look polished. Because there's somebody that's looking at me and they're saying, well, if Zakiya looked that way, then it's okay for me to look that way. And so it almost gives them permission to be polished and to look appropriate and to look beautiful and carry themselves in a certain way. So, you know, young women and women alike have to be cognizant all the time that there are other young ladies that are looking at them because they may not have someone in their home showing them and teaching them, you know, how to dress.
Right. For the Bible, it's biblical. You know, it said teach our kids as they should go.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And our children can only be what they see. And so if they're constantly seeing, you know, women not taking care of themselves or wearing their hair any kind of way, then they think that that's okay.
It's okay.
Right. And sometimes it is okay in certain circumstances. But, you know, we want you to always put your best foot forward.
And we're not just talking about a suit or a business suit for a lady. This is just, you know, man, when I'm at home, I put my spandex on and, you know, I let my hair down and, you know, I'm chilling.
Spandex, sure.
Well, whatever you call them things. Pantyhose. No, I don't put no pants. Wait a minute.
No.
Jogging tight pants. Yeah. What do you call them things?
Joggers.
Joggers. Okay. All right. Man, you're testing me here, Ms. Thomas.
It's important for, you know, like I said, coming up, I had a stepmother, but still, you know, we got to make sure we pay it forward.
Yeah.
Or reach back and grab another young lady. Ooh. You know, like I just told a young lady, I was fortunate enough when I flew to Boston last week, I met one, I call them the Fabulous Five. We just had five females to finish the Mississippi law enforcement training academy as highway patrolmen. Never has that happened.
That's
so, you know, awesome. And I was just like, I said, I got to meet them. And, you know, God has put it where I got on the plane. I saw the young lady. I said, she looked familiar. Mm-hmm. We ended up sitting beside each other. She was flying to Atlanta. And I said, well, I am so honored to meet you. And she was like, no, I want to be like you. You in your year 25. I said, but, you know, as a 25-year veteran, to see you all come along, mm-hmm. I call y'all the Fabulous Five. Mm-hmm. She said, you have already given us a name. I said, yes, ma'am, I have. I said, I'm fortunate enough to meet you. I'll meet another young lady when I go to Natchez in 2 weeks in September. She said, you're really on a mission to meet all of us. I said, yes, because somebody did it for me when I was in year one. Mm-hmm. So I got to reach back and grab you and show you and say, hey, come on, you can make it 25 years in this game too. Come on. I'm not gonna tell you that ain't gonna be hard. And I made sure before I got off that plane, she had my phone number, she was on my Facebook page. I made sure, and I even reached out once I got settled and text her because she was gonna drive back. She was going over to get her vehicle. Mm-hmm. I text her that night and say, I just wanted to make sure you was back at home. And she said, Miss Chris, you don't know what this means to me. When I come to the courthouse, I'm coming to look for you. I say, I'm there. So it's important that we pour back over into our girls, our young ladies, you know, be that example. Because like she said, they're watching us.
Absolutely.
And we have no idea. I've gotten so many calls from younger ladies that's raising their sons and said, you know, you make it look so easy. I said, no, you just don't know.
You don't know.
My knees are feeling so
praying every night.
Right. I said, but I just try to make sure, you know, use your Bible as your guide. And that's what I tell everybody.
See
it. You got to use that Bible as your guide. That's the best thing. That's the only book I know you won't go wrong in.
Amen.
Amen.
Great job.
Miss Brenda.
Myers, talk to me.
You know, in the age of social media, it is really important how we project ourselves on social media. There are some bad examples on social media, you know, women being scantily clad, is that how they say it? You know, and then young girls are, they're watching that.
Right.
So just a little story about this young lady. She was on TikTok and she—
Who? You playing checkers?
Stop it. TikTok is a social media outlet.
When did that come out?
Oh, no.
Stop it.
Oh, my God.
But anyway, she was on TikTok, and I have a TikTok page. So she saw my pictures on TikTok, and she said to her grandmother, she said, Grandmother, this lady is so pretty. Do you know her? And it just so happened that her grandmother was a friend of mine.
Wow.
And so we went to lunch, and she brought her granddaughter.
No, she did
not. Yes, she did. And she got to meet me, and she was like, wow, you know, I really, really like you. And she pulled up all my pictures and was showing me, you know, so that let me know, even the, because she was like maybe 7 or 8, 8 or 9 maybe, and she was already watching. So I was an example to her, you know what I'm saying? So we have to make sure that we do, in all areas of our lives, you know, be careful about how we present ourselves. And one other thing I want to say.
Hold that one other thing, okay? Please.
Yes.
Please, we'll come back with that one other thing.
Okay.
Okay? Hey guys, thank you for tuning in. Guys, this has been a great, great, great show. And I'm so honored and so pleased the way the show went. You know, we haven't done a ladies show, period. So you guys are trailblazers. Everybody say trailblazers.
Trailblazers.
Leaders.
Leaders.
Professional.
Professionals.
We got this.
Keep it real.
We got this. We want to get this to you guys. So what we're going to do, we're going to follow up on that conversation with Miss Brenda Miles. Finish up that beautiful conversation you had before we went to break.
Yeah, well, it was just one other thing I wanted to say. You know, dressing is a part of it, but you have to have a walk in life that's all about confidence. You have to have God, you know, first, be God-fearing and let Him lead you through your path. And life is a journey. You know, you're going to go through a whole lot of things, good times, bad times, you know, you're going to go through all of that. But one of the things I always talk about or teach the people that the girls that I'm talking to is about fear. Mm-hmm. The acronym for fear is face everything and rise. And so that's why what I like to tell them, you're going to come to obstacles and things are going to happen, but just face it head on, you know, just face it. And then you can overcome.
Lady up. We say man up.
Man up, lady up. Yeah. So, you know, you can do it. You know, dream big. The sky's the limit for you. You are your only limit.
You are great.
Yes.
Our ladies, our young ladies.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. So, yeah, just always think positive and put your best face forward.
Amen. Ms. Powell.
One thing that I like to leave is be the one.
Ooh! Say,
be the one.
Be the one. Ooh, boy. Where my mic at?
You dropped it?
be
the
one.
Ooh, I love it. Love it.
Powerful women have said on the stage today. I want to encourage uniqueness, and I always have. You were born unique. Don't die a copy.
Amen.
Mm. But at the same time, you want to be the one. And if you feel that you don't have that support, seek it out. Don't be afraid to do so. Mm. You know, but I always encourage young ladies through mentorship, whatever. And I like to thank Zakiya for joining me yesterday in part of an empowerment workshop that we facilitated, and thank you as well.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you for having me.
But it's essential that we know that we're not taking away your freedom to be you.
Okay.
We're just wanting you to refine it, structure it, and look for someone to aspire to be.
Amen.
Be that one. Be that leader.
Be that one. I love that. I'm going to take that to heart. Guys, ladies. I want to thank you guys. And I say guys, that's what we say in St. Louis. Guys mean everybody.
Mean everybody.
So, yeah, Ms. Stewart, you know about that. Ms. Wilson, we had up north. So ladies, I want to thank you guys from the bottom of my heart. The first ever Talk Fashion with Robert Ford and friends. And to our young ladies out there, thank you for tuning in. I promise you, you're going to be great. So at this time, we want to reintroduce our ladies. They're going to show you the beautiful outfit they have on. So, Mr. Larry, you ready to key that music up? We're going to show these beautiful ladies in a beautiful outfit. So, at this time, Miss Brenda Miles. Absolutely beautiful. Miss Powell. Go ahead on. Slide down a bit. Yes. Miss Summers. Represent Summers. Come on. Absolutely beautiful.
As I was walking by, I saw you standing there with a smile.
Yes. Yes.
Looking shiny, come
Miss
on.
Thomas.
I thought you'd wanna hang for a while.
Go ahead on, girl.
Well,
does that blue look
like
good on her?
Be with you. And you know.
Guys, once again.
I hope you care for the time.
Thank you for tuning in. Talking Fashion with Robert Ford and friends. And my beautiful friends. Mr. Brenda Myers, Miss Powell, Miss Summers, and Miss Thomas. God bless you guys. We love you. Young ladies, stay positive. Dream big. The world is yours. Go get it. God bless. That's what we do. Talking Fashion. Good boys and young ladies. Young man and young ladies. Come on, ladies, where we at?